Here we go. We're going to put a bearing in a 2008 Pontiac Grand Prix. So here we go. Jack up the vehicle. Just happen to have a jack. Unless you got a regular jack, make sure you secure it good. Jack it up. Get it off the ground. I would prefer not to have tie shine on it because it doesn't, it would stick on you. Let me get my battery. $99, Harbor 2. Makes your job a lot easier. It's simple. Make sure you put the lugs out the way. Move the tire. I like to put my tire up under the car just in case something goes wrong. I got something going to catch me. Okay. Have to get the steering wheel turned to the right. Towards the hub, not the caliper, because I want to take the whole thing off. Okay, it's on there pretty tight. The foot power, you have to. That never been also trying to be a little stubborn. The gun back on it. So now pulling it back off. Okay. Here we go. Now we're going to take off the center bolt. That'll loosen the axle up to allow it to back up. Okay, here we go with the new one. Match it up. Make sure our lug pattern is correct. By just touching it together like that. See here? Which it is. Take a look at my old pattern. See where all this is. Notice I got a notch right here. Around here, a notch here. Make sure you line that notch up. Which you're probably not going to go in but one way anyway. But I see the notch part was down and I'm up. So next time I'm going to put it back. This point, I'm gonna put my big socket back on. What that'll do is help me pull this thing up. But don't want to do that. Okay, now let's get one of the bolts back in. Get it started here. Go on here. Yeah, push on that. Get the bolt started. Incorrectly. So, the way to do that is to tighten up on the socket a little bit. So I'm gonna go ahead and start these bolts on that axle is back. At least stick them in here. Get me a good start. So, flip my ratchet back around and then tighten up all the three bolts again. I'm watching the lineup, making sure to stay lined up. Put my plate back where it went. And I'm not going to tighten them down all the way. I'll tighten them a little bit at a time so they'll go down even.
Let's just turn the steering wheel back to be able to tighten up the other bolts on it. Now we put the caliper back on. Notice I set the caliper on there for now. What I'm gonna do is put a nut on here. What that's gonna do is stabilize my rotor until I put this thing on. Put that in. That'll take the place of those things we took off. That's the reason they put them on, to keep the rotor from falling off. Remember when we talked about these things, and that's what I'm doing now. Stabilizing it till I put it together, and that's what they do with these. So, find my caliper bolt, and notice I didn't take the caliper loose. I took the whole caliper mounting bracket, not the caliper itself. See, those bolts still in there, but the mounting bolt bracket. That way I won't have to take the mounting bolt bracket off and the caliper, and then get it all pieces lost, all of that. So, anything. Plus, it's easier. So get your bolt started. Now shaking it around, and squeeze it out, make sure it's level. I always make sure that you, when you put a new bolt in, another bolt in, make sure the bolt start so it can be accurate. And at the bottom, now that I got the top one in, put it in like so. That way, you'll have it together. Find your socket that I use here, 15. Get the iron ratchet. Making sure it's tight, so you don't trust that. Go back behind it. It's tight. And that's tight. So now I can confidently take this off. And there we go. And that's how you put on a wheel hub assembly. Make sure you can put it back straight or leave it like that. But anyway, there we go. We thank you for joining me on YouTube. If you enjoy this video, subscribe, hit like, and let me know in the comments any questions. I'll be glad. Yes, because I'm on YouTube every day. All right, have a great day.